What's good in the hood, YouTube? This is Crazy Santa Rice, everyone here. Bring another video. Today I'm bringing you a video on the Power Rangers movie 2017. Today they decided to reveal more merchandise for the movie. Now, for many people, they've already bought a bunch of the items, such as the interactive Megazord, or maybe you've already bought the T-Rex, or the Power Sword. Those are coming slowly to stores, and that should be interesting. But now we got more items that are coming to stores. As far as when they're gonna release, it's not said. Hopefully, maybe late December, I would guess. Could be sooner. I don't know anything for a fact. It might be January. I don't know yet. But they were revealed, and hopefully we'll get them soon. So I wanted to go through each of these items because they are, and I'm going to go through them in a way that makes sense from the ones that probably are worth the most to talk about to the ones that are least. So I'm going to start with least to most. So the first thing I want to talk about is the Red Ranger mask that was shown off. Looks like a standard mask. Power Rangers has been doing that for years. I mean, think of it this way. They just released the training set for Ninja Steel. They've done that in the past for Dino Charge. They've done that in the past for Samurai and Megaforce and Super Megaforce. They always do it. It's very common for them to do a training set just because kids like to dress up as their favorite characters. And usually it's the red that they tend to do, although there have been some exceptions where they've done like gold or something, or like, you know, usually the Special Ranger and the leader tend to get it, and sometimes like one of the other guys or two guys. You know, I don't remember exactly how they did it for Dino Charge. I feel like they did black, red, and maybe blue as well, and gold. Don't hold me to that, but I believe that was what they did this time, and maybe green. I forget if they did green, but that's pretty big compared to previous ones where I don't think they do as many. But you get my point. Overall, though, I want to just say it looks fine. There's not much going on with it. You know, it's just the mask. I mean, those were training sets where they at least gave you like a cheap knockoff version of like the more expensive weapon or something like that. This is just a mask. So if you want a mask, great. And it's not going to be something like the Legacy helmet where, you know, it's a real helmet and I mean, you could cosplay with it. This is not like that. This is something where, you know, it's a cheap it's probably a cheap mask that you could use for Halloween that isn't going to be overly expensive. So understand that now. Moving on, though, I want to go into the figures. Obviously they're doing the 5-inch figures for the Rangers. One thing to note, obviously, the only one that actually has a weapon is Red. He has the Power Sword, which is odd to most people, although you could look at the Legacy line and say the only ones that got weapons were Green and Red if you got the, San Diego Comic-Con exclusive version of the figure with the Power Sword. So understand this now. That's kind of questionable. I mean, the regular toy line, you know, they each have the same weapon, but at least it's better than nothing. I mean, the others, they have something, which is like this weird aura or energy around their arm, which is not bad. I mean, that's better than nothing, but I feel like that's kind of a waste. Personally, I would have hoped, and a lot of people would have hoped, that they would have given them their individual weapons in a new movie styling, and hopefully, this is something, speaking of which, hopefully that doesn't mean that the other Rangers aren't going to have weapons. Like, that's my fear. The fact that they don't have them here makes me wonder, are we going to actually have the other Rangers having weapons, or is there just going to be the Power Sword? Because if that is the case, that's terrible, in my opinion. And I feel like that's true, because it's really not the best idea to do that, because people expect to see, you know, the Power Lance, the Power Axe, the Power Bow, and the Power Daggers. I mean, would you not blame me for saying that? I mean, it's true. It's definitely a fact that people would expect that. So that's why I'm a little bit concerned as to why that is, and hopefully they'll release an additional release with the weapons, or something else, even though that seems ridiculous to me. I don't know anything for a fact. Don't hold me to that. And for all we know, things could be adjusted slightly. But the fact that they're releasing this now and it looks this way makes me a little concerned. Not saying it's the worst thing ever, and don't get me wrong, Red almost always gets his weapon, which is why it makes sense in some ways that at least Red gets his weapon. But in my opinion, I think they all should. I'm just saying. But we'll see what happens. The last one that I wanted to talk about was Alpha 5. Now, Alpha 5 obviously just got revealed 2 days ago, and what we're assuming possibly is that they might be releasing a trailer tomorrow, since Brazil Comic Con is going to have a panel there, and they did the New York Comic Con, and then they had their panel, and then they ended up releasing a trailer, so maybe they'll do the same thing this time. Also, they're releasing merchandise, which was the same thing for New York Comic Con, so maybe we're expecting it to be the same exact idea. Merchandise, panel, movie trailer. Could that happen? Maybe. And personally, I wouldn't be surprised if it does. But we'll have to wait and see. Overall, though, I would say that looking at this Alpha 5, though, I would say that it looks pretty terrible. As far as comparing it to the movie version that we've seen from the movies, it looks pretty terrible compared to the official concept art. Now, what I mean by that is, it doesn't look like it looks bad in certain areas. Not bad overall. I shouldn't say that. Understand this now. I like the overall body, but where I feel like they screwed up was the eyes. Now, you may think, so you're saying that you like the stock eyes? That's not what I'm saying. But what I think that it's important to remember is that I think that in this case they should have had the stock eyes, because it looks like two orange globs that are on each side of its eyes. That's kind of lame, and it just sort of seems like a stupid, let's just put something extra there, and also the other thing to remember, they're not even painted. They're just an orange glob that looks like it's probably, something squishy that you could probably squeeze very easily, and it's supposed to act like eyes. Now, hopefully they are painted, but if they're just globs, that's kind of lame. I'm sorry to say it, that's pretty lame, because give us a sense that, like, these are eyes. These aren't just, like, little bits that have very little meaning. The other thing is that the dome is very much so a spherical-like shape, and I'm not saying it's a problem, but the way that they did it is so big. They made the spear so giant, and I get that they want it to be very visible, but it looks really weird in my opinion. And also, he has this weird proportions with his body where his stomach is gigantic. I mean, that was how the concept art was, but I mean, it really looks weird with the toy, with the stomach being gigantic, the legs being super tiny, and the arms, and that also kind of makes me wonder, as well as the head, although I'm curious if this is going to be a top-heavy figure just based off of the proportions and how the figure is structured, because I could totally see this being a figure where it would be extremely top-heavy with its stomach and its head being the way it is. Understand this now, I don't know anything for a fact. I haven't seen this in person. I've only seen the images online, so I can't really make an official judgment in that way. And for all we know, at the Brazil Comic Con tomorrow, they might show off the official images of this, and we might get a better sense of how they look in person from that perspective rather than just from individual images. But overall, I would like to say this. I don't mind any of this. Of these items, I haven't bought anything yet. I'm still waiting for stuff, and the stores that I've gone to haven't really put out any of this merchandise yet. So I'm going to be going this weekend and in the next couple weeks to some other stores just to try to find some stuff. I'm looking to get the T-Rex and all the Zords, really. Possibly the Morpher. Most likely all five figures, and maybe even Alpha, and possibly the Power Sword, although that's like a non essential one for me. But I definitely want the figures and the Zords at minimum, and possibly the Morpher, and maybe Alpha. We'll see what happens. I don't know anything for a fact. I don't know what to expect at the stores that I go to, and I'm also looking to get more legacy figures because I do have the whole legacy line, and I did reviews, but I haven't posted them yet, and I plan on posting them fairly soon the first wave of figures, where I did the first wave for Ninja Storm and the first wave for Mighty Morphin, because I have the complete wave. So I am going to release those soon. It's just I've been busy with other stuff, and also I've been posting stuff related to the movie, so it's sort of like, when do I choose to post things? Anyway, guys, please remember to like, comment, subscribe. Tell me what you guys think of these figures and merchandise. Are you going to buy any of these items, and which ones will you buy and why? Leave your comments below, and please remember to like, comment, subscribe. Check out my Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, and subscribe. And that's about it for me, guys. And also Facebook. Like, comment, subscribe, check, and answer the question time at the bottom. That's about it for me. So bye bye, guys.